Hello, welcome to NetVN channel. In this video I show you how to monitor network bandwidth with MRTG. With MRTG you can monitor the bandwidth of the server, router or switch over the network. First you download the latest version of MRTG from the official homepage. After downloading, I extracted to C partition of Windows computer. I will rename the folder to MRTG to ease the next steps. To use the PRTG tool, a Windows computer requires Perl to be installed. Thanks for the detailed instructions on how to install and configure it on the homepage of MRTG. On the MRTG homepage there are instructions for many different operating systems. Here I refer to the installation and configuration instructions on the Windows operating system. To download Perl to my computer I have to create a new free account. So that you don't have to wait long I have prepared a free account so I will log in with that account. There are many options for me to download but MRTG requires a Windows computer with Perl installed so I will download Perl. I choose the latest version of Perl. Next is the operating system. Although I am installing on Windows 11 operating system, I can download the version for Windows 10 operating system as well. The selections required before the download were set, I scrolled to the bottom of the page and clicked install. There are two ways to install Perl and I find it easier to install using the command line. I just copy the command and paste it into the Windows command window and wait for the installation to complete. Then copy and paste the command as above. Wait a moment to complete the installation of Perl on Windows operating system. To monitor the network traffic of a device or a server I need to enable SNMP on it. Here I will monitor the bandwidth of a Windows server so I will enable SNMP on it. I have a Windows server ready with IP address 192.168.1.254. This server does not have SNMP installed so I will install it. You install SNMP on the Windows server as above. You can also install SNMP on Windows 10 and Windows 11 operating systems. After installing SNMP for Windows server I set it up as follows. I allow monitoring this server from any IP address. You can limit the IP address allowed to monitor this server if you want. Next I set the SNMP community string to public. You can set up another character string if you want, and you should write it down to set it up in the next step. To ensure that the SNMP settings on the server are applied I recommend that you restart the SNMP service. I have finished setting up SNMP on Windows Server, now I will monitor its traffic using MRTG. Go back to a Windows 11 computer with MRTG installed and Perl installed. I browse to the bin folder inside a folder called MRTG. Here I open command window and check if MRTG tool is working. If you get the above message, it's working fine. To monitor the target Windows server, I usually command as instructed to create a configuration file as above. I replace the default IP address with the IP address of the target Windows server. As mentioned in the previous step, the IP address of the server is 192.168.1.254. And here is the config file I got. It's called mrtg.cfg. Next, I open the configuration file using the available Notepad software on Windows operating system. As per the instructions, I add two lines at the top of the file. The first line to set the directory to save the Windows Server traffic monitoring results. Because there is no such folder on my computer, I will create a new folder. On partition C, I create a new folder named www. In the www folder, I create a new folder named mrtg. I need one more line because by default the result is only fetched once, so the second line will get me the result every 5 minutes. After adding the top two lines as above, don't forget to save the changes. Next, I will test the result with the configuration file I just got. We open the folder named MRTG to save the monitoring results. On the command prompt, I run the command perl mrtg.cfg. mrtg.cfg is the configuration file that was created earlier. It stores the traffic monitoring configuration of the target Windows server. You will see in the mrtg folder appear files to save traffic monitoring results. I open the file with the extension HTML with any web browser on my computer to see the result. The result will be saved every 5 minutes. My job is to wait. Here are the basic steps to monitor traffic with MRTG. The next steps, I set up to run the MRTG tool every time the Windows operating system boots. Or how can I monitor multi-device traffic with MRTG? Next, I create a shortcut to run a command to monitor the Windows server traffic. I will replace Perl with WebPerl to run MRTG tool without console. After creating a new shortcut, I update start in a CMRTG bin. Now I need to check if MRTG tool is really working or not by opening Task Manager. I browse and check services running on Windows 11 operating system. And here it is, the WebPerl service is running. I can close the console window and the MRTG tool still works. I check the services again to make sure the traffic monitoring tool is still working. So every try worked fine, I got rid of the console window. Next, I added the newly created shortcut to the startup folder so that it is launched every time the Windows operating system is started. That way I don't need to start MRTG manually. I open the Windows startup folder with a run window. Then I just drag and drop the newly created shortcut. I restarted the computer with MRTG installed to check the results. Wait a moment for the Windows 11 computer to start. Just like last time, I opened Task Manager to check if WPARL is running. Great, WPARL service is running like MRTG tool is working. I created a new shortcut to the target server's network interface to make it easier to monitor traffic. You name it to match your server. Shortcut created successfully. I just double-click on the shortcut to monitor the network interface traffic of the target Windows server. As mentioned, I will show you how to add multiple monitor devices with MRTG. Want to monitor another device? I create a new configuration file. I open the bin folder in the MRTG folder. Here I open the command window as above. Now I want to monitor the traffic of the router whose IP address is 10.11.32.140. Of course, on my router SNMP is enabled. I will create a new configuration file called mrtg1.cfg to monitor my router. Just like the configuration file of the Windows server, I add two lines on top as above. The first line defines the directory where the traffic monitoring results are saved. The folder named MRTG is saving the Windows Server monitoring results. So to save the router monitoring results, I created a new folder named MRTG1. The remaining line will help me get the result every 5 minutes. Next, I create a shortcut to launch router traffic monitoring every time the OS boots. I just cloned the Windows Server's traffic monitoring shortcut. Then I edited the new shortcut to match the router device. I renamed the shortcut to match the device I want to monitor. I replaced the mrtg.cfg file with the mrtg1.cfg file and saved it. Now I check the traffic monitoring results for the router device. In the folder named MRTG1 will appear files that store the results of traffic monitoring of the router's interfaces. Next, I create a shortcut to monitor the router's WAN interface traffic. so I can monitor multiple devices at the same time using MRTG. Above are the basic steps to monitor the network traffic of devices using MRTG. Good luck, thanks for watching, don't forget to like and subscribe.